kill me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and we are back playing a little bit more Birthdays at the Beginning, and today is going to be the Age of Mammals, the birth of mammals, and therefore also the death of the dinosaurs. Not a happy moment. It turns out the real reason for the extinction of the dinosaurs was not a meteor, but it was myself. At last, it's time to move on to the birth of mammals, specifically the birth of Adelobasilius. This is the first mammal. It likes to hide in the shade of the forest. The environments that support mammals and dinosaurs could not be more different. So as mammals begin to flourish, there's a high chance of dinosaurs going extinct. Could there be a deeper meaning behind the birth and extinction of these dinosaurs? No. So, I have been recording this episode about four times this morning. I've had a lot of problems getting hold of this Adelobasilius, and I've kind of gone back and forth as to my reasoning why, but I finally figured out how we're going to get hold of this thing. It's been a royal pain in the ass, I'm not going to lie, but I'm going to show you what I was thinking. So we're going into the library, we go into the tree, and we go over here to the Adelobasilius, there it is. So we need birth temp 30 to 40 degrees, birth moisture 10 to 64. Those are the main two things we need to focus on to get this little mouse. Now, the first time I recorded this video, I just focused on those. I got those temperatures, I got those birth moistures, and then I failed. And nothing happened for an exceptionally long time. Like, I left it playing for 20 minutes and this little guy was never birthed. So then I went back and realised, if we look at the tree, that we actually need this little guy first, a small lizard that scurries through hot grasslands. So what I did was set the temperature to the right thing for this little lizard, birth temperature 35 to 45, and the right birth moistures, because the lead-on creature to this is the Dimetrodon. So I thought, right, that makes sense, okay? However, because we've made the world so warm because of the dinosaurs, we now don't have any Dimetrodons, which the birth temperature for the Dimetrodon is really, really cool. It needs to be like a really low temperature. So what we need to do is low temperature for the Dimetrodon, raise it back up for the lizard, and then drop it down a little bit more for the Adelo. If we raise it up to 35, 36, 37, that should hit both of these guys. So we're going to drop it right down to the mid-20s and then right back up to the mid-30s. And hopefully that combination finally means I will finish this godforsaken mission, because I've been here for about 2 hours. And it's completely my fault. I should have realized a long time ago what I was doing wrong, but I didn't. This is the world we live in now. But what this means we get to do, ladies and gentlemen, is we get to make a whole lot of mountains, because, well, we need to lower the temperature, and the best way to lower temperature is to get rid of water and make mountains. And because the water is such a weird shape already, and because we're kind of clicking around a little bit, we're going to end up some really cool looking little shapes here, I think. I'm going to really try to, you know, spread it out a little bit, make it look interesting. I complained, I think, last video about the lack of sort of mountainous regions, and at the end of the day we had to have a lack of mountainous regions because we really wanted a high temperature for our world, and if you have lots of mountains it lowers the temperature. Well, that's not a thing anymore. We don't have to worry about that anymore. Now we can make lots of big old mountains, you know? Big old mountain range. How much better does that look? It's really nice when you can combine the water and the mountain ranges. We might pop, I've got a couple of items called Global Cooling, and I suspect we might use a couple of those, because we've got a long old way to go in terms of temperature, and it will take about a billion years. I don't really have a billion years. So, let's hop into item menu, and we're gonna... Didn't mean to do that. Okay, we're gonna go over here to Global Cooling, and we're gonna pop a few of these. And by a few of these, I mean buttloads. This is going to be super, super bad for the dinosaurs. They're going to hate this. Absolutely hate it. But the Dimetrodon will love it. Down to 29. I think I'm going to aim for 26. So let's just keep going for a little bit. Two to go, and then hopefully we'll be able to get ourselves some lovely Dimetrodons. And then once we've got a decent number of Dimetrodons, we're going to raise the temperature back up, because what we need is the Dimetrodons to last long enough that we can birth these new creatures, because the Dimetrodons will die out, I believe, if I raise the temperature back up to 35, because that's kind of where I was sitting for a long time. I don't know. I don't know if there's like a death range and a birth range. So maybe if you go outside of the birth range, the creature can survive in a small but stable population. Don't really know. Doesn't really matter. Need to get 2 more degrees. Let's grab our big old tool. No jokes. And raise up this area over here as well. 1 more degree. Anything new on the map? Doesn't look like it. There we go. I just want to make sure it looks okay as well. Doesn't matter if it goes on. There we go. There we go. 26 degrees, that'll do. Now, it is unfortunately still actually 44 degrees. It's still very, very hot. Because it takes a little bit of time, but you can see the air temperature on the right-hand side. It's going to start slowly dropping. We're going to see our dinosaurs die out at a pretty alarming rate, I think. Now, with the dinosaurs, they can survive till about 35 degrees. You'll see Stegosaurus actually went up there. You can see the campus has gone up. It's not a dinosaur. Ooh, ooh, ooh! Oh, come back, no! New dinosaur, new dinosaur! Where is it? I don't see it. Oh, it's over there on the left. They always hang around here. They just do not leave this tiny little area. Where are you? Ah, there you are. Oh, it's a tiny little raptor. Parchioraptor. Parchioraptor? God only knows. It's a raptor. It's cute. That's what matters. Cool. And where we go. Now, the annoying thing is, if I had done this when I first initially got Dimetrodon... Ooh! Now we'll get it later. If I had done this when I first initially got Dimetrodon, we wouldn't have to go back and do all this temperature changing now, you know? So it's worth kind of getting what you can when you get to those stages, but... The world is looking cooler. I'd like some more sort of around here in that sort of top corner where it's very arid. It'd be quite nice to have a mountain range around there as well. Tell you what, we've got a couple new things. Let's hop quickly in. We've got some conifers. My name's Connor, so that is obviously the best tree. Let's nip over here. I'd love like a really lush, verdant, like a big old conifer forest. That'd be awesome. Don't know why that would be really cool, but it would be. Oh my god, what is that? Why are you up there? That seems like a terrible place. Oh, birth temperature 10 to 20. Ah, right, so it has to be birthed up there because it's such a high region. It can't be birthed on the others because the temperature is obviously a little bit lower. There's another one just over there. I think this is like a little starfish. Like I said, I've recorded this video like 4 or 5 times so far, so... I have seen a few of these before, although I... Sorry, little... Oh, that poor little raptor. There's a little coelacanthus in there. And then, yeah, there we go. Woofy award. Woofy. I'm gonna call him Wolfie. And speed up time. Air temperature's dropped to 30 now, so we're definitely getting a lot closer. Look at all that. Look at all those things that have just died out. All my dinosaurs are pretty much dead. Okay, we just got a buttload of new stuff. Let's just hop in, and then we're waiting for Dimetrodon to appear. Now, Dimetrodon should actually get an announcement thing. We have had it before, but, because it went extinct at some point. I don't know when it went extinct, but it did go extinct at some point. It should get like a little announcement when we get another one. Hooray! Good old Boris. He knows what he's about. 2 more species down here at the bottom. It's nice having this little arid area on the bottom right because the temperature changes, but that area always stays nice and dry. So any creature that thrives in that kind of environment, we're going to make without really kind of focusing or targeting it. Look at this little Diplocalus. Awesome. Straight out of Jurassic World. Little furry so-and-so. And I assume this is a weird little planet. Yeah. Cool beans. And go. So, we're keeping an eye out for Dimetrodon. There it is, Dimetrodon, 2,200. So I want a good population of Dimetrodons, like a few, probably a few 100,000, really. I'm hoping they're gonna start to... Oh my god, 2 new things again. Ah, 3 new things. So many new things. Stop it. I need to capture when they appear, because things just die out so quickly. You never know when you're going to lose them. What is it? Oh, it's a Diplocalus variant. Maybe colder temperatures, that's why it's up here on the hill. It lives on the coast. Ah, Diceratocalus. I was saying in another video, I'm going to say it again because I think it's an interesting point. People have commented about this, and I kind of don't know where I sit with this. In a way, this game is like, it's very good, educationally, because it introduces all these things that most people have never heard of at the end of the day. A lot of people haven't heard of a lot of the creatures in this game, particularly, I mean, a lot of you guys are on this channel because we all love dinosaurs and extinct creatures and stuff, but you think for laymen, well, I suppose we are, but just for the general populace who maybe aren't as well-versed, a lot of this stuff is going to be new to them. On the other hand, a lot of the information about this new stuff is completely inaccurate. So, is it good or is it bad? It reminds me of a conversation I have with someone where basically, if you go to a zoo, right, and there's parents there with the kids, that's really good because... Ooh, Ichthyomimus, awesome. Yeah, it'll be fine. That's really good, right? We want kids to go to zoos, see animals, get interested in zoology and paleontology and biology and all this kind of stuff. We want kids to be inspired to do that kind of thing. On the other hand, every time I go to the zoo and I hear parents talking to their kids, everything they're saying is incredibly incorrect, you know? So, I don't really know how I feel about it. It's kind of this weird balance between the right idea, the right effort, but done in a bad way, sort of. I've not seen Dimetrodon pop up at all on this right-hand side. I need lots of Dimetrodons. Where are they? More Dimetrodons. I've actually had a little bit of an idea as well. If we find... Oh, okay, we've got a couple new things to pop over here. But if we find our Dimetrodons right here, what we're going to do, something we've not really done before. Because this has been so frustrating for me, I really want to just kind of nail this bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab ourselves a seed of evolution. Or mutation. No, evolution, right? Because what we want is to evolve the Dimetrodon into the next creature that we need. I'm going to use two, because I know there's at least three creatures that come off the Dimetrodon. Now, some of them may be evolution mutation ones, which means it would still work, but... Okay, good stuff. Is there anything else on that map for me to... I'm sure there should be something else, but I don't see any pink. Net, whatever. Pew! So hopefully, we're about to get ourselves the thing we need. Right, we just got tons of stuff. Now, they're all going to die really quickly because it's not the right environment, okay, for any of them. But if we can get number 80, which is the creature we need... Hello? Oh my god, what are you? We have a crocodile. A Parasuchus. That's awesome. I want to get a good little view. Where's V? There it is. Oh my god, I forgot how terrible this camera is. Hi, buddy. We got a crocodile. Cool. Where you going? Hey, go back here. Crocodilio, okay. We should have a couple of new things, although... Oh yeah, there's one up at the top. And there's one at the bottom left as well. Hopefully one of these is the creature I'm looking for. I'm just looking for one creature. It could be this little dude. That looks... We're looking for number 80, right? Number 80. Is this the right one? Yes, Diphyodon. A small lizard that scurries through hot grasslands. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay. I'm going to make this work. We've got us my win. I've done a little Googling, right? I've had a look, and it seems a lot of people are having this exact same issue. A lot of people are struggling with this mission in particular. I am going to Seed of Evolution this little dude two more times. That is going to spawn the creatures I'm looking for, right? My temperature is set up for them to survive. It just is. It's the right temperature for them to be okay. So, fast forward time. This is going to work. There they are, Diphyodon. I need the Diphyodon to keep increasing in population over and over again. And it's dead. Why is it dead? It's got everything it needs. Why? Why? Oh, kill me. And it's dead again. Why is it dead again? Why is it dead? Ah, it was down there at the bottom. I didn't see where it was. So, I have one more idea, but this is triggering the freaking hell out of me. Where's my Dimetrodon? There it is. Okay. Okay, what we need to do is start time and keep an eye out. Right. Diphyodon, 2000. We found the Diphyodon. I think it's down here in the bottom right. I know they're going to die if I skip forward time at all. Because they do every single time. They just do. They're not the most survivable little creature. This little dude right here is the one I need to survive. So what I'm thinking is, do I have an item? You know what? This is the way to do it. Bam. Please, just work. Just, please. Please, just give me my little mammal. I don't care anymore. We did it! Finally! It took so long and I had basically... Oh, whatever. Whoa, a mammal was born. Happy birthday. I'm beginning to see the path towards civilization. Mammals are the progenitors of mankind. From here, creative variety of evolutions give birth to mankind, and civilization will finally come. Our first step towards that goal begins with the birth of Delta Theridum. It's a mouse that migrated from the forest to the plains. It may seem weird, but I assure you this is completely necessary. So, what do we need? The temperature is... I need my Adelobacillus to survive. That's the first thing. I'll tell you what, let's grab them first before they all disappear on me. I need to add them to my little book. And then I've got to hope that everything is okay for them to survive. Get lots of... Oh, is that a snake? Oh, it is a snake. Cool. Hello. Cool. Oh, it's a legless reptile. Actually is different. Hello, cutie. Okay, so that's like the Diphaidon follow-up. I guess this one at the top is my little mouse then. Our very first mammal. It's been hard work, it really has. If I just used those things from the start, it would have been fine, but the game just didn't want me to do it naturally, you know? I really wanted to, I really did. Yay! Oh, look at the little windows. Okay. Okay, so... Everything should be okay for that little guy to propagate. Should be. Not convinced. Okay, I don't care if they die. I care about my mouse. Yes, 135! They're propagating! They're propagating! Awesome! 175,000, 236... Okay, they're spreading like absolute goddamn wildfire is what they're doing. And there we go! Easy peasy! It's time to birth primates! This species has an important connect to mankind and then to civilization. Eosimius, right, this is our final goal for the episode. Let's go ahead and grab this new type of mouse that we just got. Who is up here somewhere? Yes. Boop. Hello, buddy. Now, he needed the colder climates. That's why he's up on the thing. Oh, I feel so much better right now. So much. Oh, I just need to. Whew, right, okay. So, what do we need for our first simian? 24 degrees, Jesus. And a Delta Theridium to have appeared. Now, we've already done that, so all we need to do is reduce the temperature. However, we don't necessarily need to reduce the temperature. That sounds crazy. But it gives you a temperature to aim for, right? But in actuality, you don't have to hit that temperature, you have to hit one near it. So it should be over here, right? It's a kitty cat! It's a mammoth! It's a bull! It's a lion! It's not a lion, it's a wolf! Shut up, Connor. Oh, I actually nearly got all the... Damn, no. Oh, God, nope. It'd be nice if it stayed in the right place. But that's fine. All the birds you get from the dinosaurs. That's pretty cool, right? Right. Eosimius. Oh my God, so cute! Birth temperature. So we do need to get the temperature down to below 27. Okay, so we do need to we are going to have to do a temperature reduction here. Because it is just, it's the bottom level of it, or the highest level of it, I guess, is so much lower than the bottom level of some of the other creatures. Alright, it's time to make the planet a little bit colder. You know what I'd like as well? What we should do is make a little fresh water area. Just so we can birth that kind of creature. Really. Actually, we might go do that as well, quickly. Let's go over here to the right-hand side. There's nothing really over here. This used to all be arid, and it's become... You know, not. So what I want to do is just make a river. I think if we do it like this, this should work pretty well. And this has the added benefit of still reducing the temperature as well, which is what I'm looking for. I'm going to do a big old river chain. Actually, I might elongate this more. I'd like a nice big area, and that way, hopefully... Any freshwater creatures we can get. And it's got the added benefit of actually doing what I want to do anyway. Boop. Now, if I've got this right, I do think the creature should be able to be born now, just because some areas will have the right temperature. We'll see if it happens whilst I'm fast forward going through time now, just get my HP back. Got a lot of Adelobacillus, which is pretty cool. The age of mammals is here, officially. Okay, boop, boop. Hope they give me a bigger brush. Oh, wait, is that a bigger brush? Oh, wait. Oh, it's huge! It's humongous! I haven't been using it. Oh, I'm sad. That's good to know, right? We've just gone up a size. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, this isn't actually that important. we'll work on that later. For now, we're just gonna do what I said. Mountains! Mountains, mountains, mountains! Everywhere mountains! And what were we aiming for? 26, was it? Something like that? Not sure how many global warming things I have, or global cooling things I have. Let's have a little look. Well, yeah, I've got 6. We can use some of those. I'll do. And then just a little bit more of this. Okay, that should, in theory, be enough. Fast forward time! Come on, baby, be good to me. Be good to me. Come on, I've been good to you. You should be good to me. Together, we're gonna make beautiful babies. And then genetically modify them for our own amusement. Got a new tree, which is exciting. Probably. Lots of things I've already had before. There we go! We got ourselves a monkey! Dry up Ithicus. So we need our Eosimius to propagate lots. Otherwise it looks like it would be pretty okay. We are going to end it here. I'm going to zoom in and meet ourselves a simian. And then what this does is it sets up very nicely for the next episode to try and get ourselves a human for the first time. Bring in proper civilization. Which I imagine is like the big final goal of the game, right? I guess we'll see. I think my Dimetrodons are still here. The Age of Dinosaurs is well and truly over. I feel like, logically, there shouldn't be a Dimetrodon, but whatever. You can see he's on the high ground because it's 26 degrees up here, whereas the low ground is still just a little bit too high. This is why you want cliffs everywhere as well, just so you've got all these variants in temperature. I want to see my monkey! Where's my monkey? There he's... Meow. Hey, buddy! Yay! We got a monkey! Awesome. Awesome, 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 awesome. Right, what I'm gonna quickly do... Okay, shut up. ...is get out of view mode. We're gonna... This might seem like a bad idea, but hear me through. He needs the room to propagate, right? And right now he doesn't have it. Now, the reason he was spawning on these cliffs is because he needed a lower temperature. But because the temperature is still going to lower down to 26, which is where it needs to be anyway, him being on a low enough area to actually make bebbers is probably a good idea. I'm going to lower the temperature just a little bit more because it's at the high range, and the high range is risky just in case. So I'm going to get it down to, say, 24. Eh, 25. Should be fine. Okay, we are going to end it there, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, one thing we're going to quickly check. Does Eosimius propagate or die? That's what we need to know. Propagates. Cool. Good stuff. Thank you for joining me. Next episode, we're going to work on getting humanity. Cheers. Much love, as always. And don't forget to hit that like button. I should remind you guys every video, just in case. It takes 2 seconds from you guys, if not less. But it really, really, really helps me out. I shall see you folks in the comments down below. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye.